Yes, it's time for a show, and we begin by saying the world is finished. No, not really. There's still hope. I took my jab, folks, before we introduced Naveen and folks who have joined us. I took my jab in my left arm. It was very pleasant, except for one thing. During the entire procedure, they ask you your age. That can be horrible. Right, both me and my wife had to do the whole, you're 40 young, that kind of thing. But they have the Aadhaar cards, you can't lie. So if you're a female model or actress and you know you've been pretending to be 41 when you're 64, be very careful because you'll say it loudly in front of all the other people. What is it, Zinat? 64, Aadhaar pe likha hai. That's it. So be very careful about that. That's all I'm saying. Otherwise, it was a painless procedure. Not too bad. They make you sit shoulder to shoulder, 20 people, so that you can catch the COVID also on your way to getting the jab. That I thought was fun. But the women at St. Elizabeth, not women, that sounds wrong. The nurses were beautiful. Really nice. Not beautiful. I'm saying all the wrong things. They were just really nice. They were really nice. Motherly, matronly. In a good way, comforting, answering questions and speaking Hindi as badly as I do, which I love when talking to the general public. Tumko pareshani nahi hona chahiye. Don't worry. Suddenly a prayer would start or something, but yeah, it was fun. Anyway, my jab's done. But I've got a bit of a cold and cough because of that, so people are staying away from me. Don't do that. That's not funny. Alright, let's start the show. We've got Naveen after a long time. Naveen, of course, has got a stage curtain behind because he performs for the people on the road. You just put that, you show them something, clap.
The era of Zoom shows, Cyrus. So wherever you go, you have to get your own curtain around, your own backdrop as a stand-up comic nowadays.
That's we have press badge. Yeah. We just come to this studio where the Wi-Fi never works. Huge building.
You have green screen. You have green screen that works.
We have green screen. Green screen, is, I think, is good for a marriage also. If you want to show people how happy you and your family are, have a green screen at home just so that you can cut to, you know, all good, we're eating dinner together, whatever.
Yeah, now when you can't have marriages with like more than 50 people, you can have the entire joint family in one album with a green screen, as simple as that. Photoshop all the uncles and aunties.
I mean, by the way, they're, that's another gray area which I think we could get to in the whole thing. Huh? Apparently, you have to go and get permission for marriages that have already been booked for April, etc., etc. So how many people? It's all a variant. There's no definite thing.
Yeah.
You may be allowed 47 on Tuesday, the 14th of April, and you may be allowed 69 people, pardon the figure, on 24th of April at 6 p.m. I don't know. But we'll come to that because that's we four gentlemen are going to solve all the issues here and explain to people what's happening, especially for Maharashtra. Silvari, please guide us along.
Okay, sure. Firstly, a lot of things happening in Maharashtra, but since you already talked about the vaccine, let's finish that vaccine thing. The center has announced that vaccination for all will not be open just yet because they're saying, something wrong with my camera. Yeah, they're saying that the vaccination for all will not be open just yet because they want to be vaccinating those in need, but not those who just want the vaccine right now, which I feel you should be opening vaccine for all. It's just the faster everyone gets vaccinated, according to me, is just the better it is. And if we have enough vaccines, then why not?
See, Amit and I, being, we're not exactly 45 plus, but people, we took advantage.
Yeah,
and exactly. We went and did and he can tell you as well, not like a mad rush.
No, so it wasn't bad.
You would think if there's a pandemic, that each hospital or each vaccine center would be like a mad rush. Everybody and their uncle coming and pushing along all the 45 plus people into the place. You didn't feel that feeling. So obviously we are, as people, not really that urgent this whole business, which is a bit scary. If the vaccine is one way to get out of this thing, not enough urgency there. I think that is one thing we have to deal with. So while they're locking down everything, I would focus more on trying to get more jabs in. Mobile clinics, good-looking women coming to your house saying, hello, my name is Renu.
I think the reason why it wasn't
you don't like Renu, I'll change the name. My name is Sangeeta.
No, I think the reason why it wasn't so crowded at some of these places was because they only do a certain number, right? Like, so I went to Bhatia Hospital to get it, and they do only 25 vaccinations in the morning and 25 vaccinations in the evening, and that's in the afternoon, and that's it, right? So when you register over there, they're only allowing that, they're only taking that many registrations. So then I'm guessing Elizabeth is the same and all the other hospitals are the same. But I think to Antariksha's point...
I'm saying... Yeah, go on.
Oh, no, I was just saying the answer to this point.
Nothing's changed. Nothing's changed. No Zoom, you're the same.
Naveen, if I'm not talking, let me eat, no?
Eating and talking, Sam.
Sorry, I'm finished. Antariksha's point.
I don't remember Antariksha's point anymore, but I think it was something along the lines of that they weren't doing targeted, right? And I think that's that they wanted to just be like, this kind of one size fits all rule across the country. that just seems like that seems foolish to me, right? They should target places which are where there are more infected people, right? I mean, like Maharashtra had 60,000 infections yesterday. I mean, 60,000 in the state yesterday. That's declared. Who knows how many actually? Because we know this now, and you all know this based on people you know, that not everybody is getting not everybody's getting tested when they should.
Tested.
Right? Yeah. They're just like, what's the point? We know we have it.
I don't know something.
We'll stay at home. You know,
and this very colorful rickshaw guy the other day who was like, they're putting us in the houses and we come to our slums. I'm like, okay, he's like, come to your slums and see, there's no virus. I'm like, of course there's no virus. Like some 4 or 5 old people died, but otherwise there's no virus. I'm like, yeah, that makes sense entirely. Because so they are living in denial, yeah. Like Dharavi and like a lot of Chuim village where I'm from in Kar.
You're sounding like my friend Kunal Vijaykar, Naveen.
I know.
You're taking an ageist look at things and saying, because of region, I will label you as useless and silly and stupid and moronic, which is a very horrible thing to do, even if it's correct. So I now will call you Kunal Vijaykar for the rest of the show. A bigot if ever I've seen one. Yeah.
Is he around?
Of course he's around, but he doesn't care. Now he's got a double jab. He doesn't care about anyone. He walks around. He's almost dancing, except he's so fat. When I say dancing, it's like just his feet moving. But yeah.
Second one?
Yeah, legally, apparently, because he's head of administration in his brother-in-law's clinic. So
he should not have gotten the second one. It's too early to get
it. Yeah, but at the time they were doing it, all the medical people and guys in clinics and all, they were going with the 4-week thing. The non-4-week thing happened after 2 days after he took the 4-week thing. And they said, especially for people, older people, they should not be taking it in 4 weeks. They should be giving 6 to 7 to 8 weeks.
Yeah.
But by then, you could untake the jab. So it's okay. He's growing breasts. Other than that, he's fine. You know, I mean, the side effects should not be painful. That's, you know, this is aesthetically different.
How was it for you? Why you got stuck yesterday, right? So
I was only worried about one thing. Being who I am, I was worried if I can lift weights in the morning. Because I felt pain immediately because, you know, my hand... She was telling me, if you have a fat arm, you feel less pain. If you work out, you have a little pain. Auto-suggesting that, I got the pain. But
by the way, Cyrus, that shirtless pic of yours broke the internet for a while, okay? Like the whole new board and everything. I'm telling you, like my gay friends were losing it. They were like, how is Cyrus a zaddy now? You know what a zaddy is? It's a daddy with a Z. So that's what you are now.
What's a Z?
Daddy with a Z?
Like the Gen Z loves you. So if a Gen Z likes finds you daddy material, then you're zaddy. When you're younger and also a daddy.
There you go, Cyrus Zaddy.
Sexual icon.
Yeah, you're a sexual icon. Now Pornhub awaits after the news that wasn't. The big that wasn't.
Yeah, people in the chat are also...
Naveen, don't listen to me. Let me tell you, that has been a very bad season for all of us. You take what you get. If the homosexual icon is the future, then that's the way.
So, I'm seeing you in suit. I'm very impressed by that itself. I'm like, fuck, there's no red shirt today. This is amazing.
I wear the same shirt to this studio. This shirt here.
Why is this hanging around over there?
Can you see the holes in my shirt?
I can.
Because I did something with some NDTV girls and they told the other girl who's with me, Payal, that can you at least wear a shirt without holes? It was almost like a Me Too case.
Yeah. Like, we don't want to look like NDTV.
This is what the government has done to us. By locking me up. I already have this idiot in the next building, you know, who starts, put your mask on. This, all those, you know, I can't bear all those guys. Yeah, you know, it's just focusing on all the small things, I think. We got to think about how to get out of this situation, not by locking people up all the time. You just got to keep the one with the comorbidities away. The really old and the really sick. The rest, just get the damn disease and move on.
But you're right, the ultra-vigilante types are the worst in every building. Like my friend, he returned from Russia after 7 years. He finished his education as a doctor. He came here to like do his further education. But by the time he came here, the exams got cancelled and he was then put to Nanavati for like four months now. No pay. He's just working the COVID cases. He's overworked. And when he came back home, like he would come back after this thing, the building secretary would not let him inside. Like he would like cure patient, your COVID thing. And he's like,
I'm out there saving lives.
Sorry?
Because of the hospital ka stigma, right?
Yeah, so he was working in the hospital like 12, 13 hours. And when he'd come home to rest, they're like, you don't come inside the building. So imagine that. So then he had to get a quarter near the hospital so he could stay there instead of coming here. And you know,
he should kick that secretary's ass because that secretary's not allowed to stop him.
But he's a big time, like
this is what I'm saying. They send that panic, anxiety through the society. Then everyone thinks like that's like racism, no? Don't take a chance. I know he's doing good work and all. We'll felicitate him in October. But in the meantime, he can't come in. Like that nurse story, we went through the nurse story. I think Naveen was around at that time, right at the beginning of last year. That nurse who was debarred.
I know what you're talking about.
I mean, it's a madness.
No, I mean, like, the thing is,
building vigilantes.
You can't let people. You see, the thing is that there are real restrictions that need to be taken over here, right? And real restrictions need to be applied. So you can't allow this kind of penny ante bullshit where people are trying to, like, you know, just fuck with stuff. You can't allow this stuff to stand. You have to throw that. You have to put them down. You have to put them down hard when this stuff happens. Like, when our building, whenever there's a stupid thing that comes up, generally, I never participate in building stuff, right? I don't get involved in it. It's not worth the effort. It's not worth the aggravation. But when they do something stupid around this COVID stuff, you have to shut them down. That, no, you cannot. Like, you know, we had this rule for the longest time that domestic servants are allowed in the house, but drivers are not allowed in the building. And I'm like, what the fuck is the sense of that? That makes no sense whatsoever, right?
And to save money, if you have the chauffeur also doing the dishes, then what?
Sorry? Well, I mean, like, you know, not most people don't function like that, Cyrus. But if they did, then I think that it would be but then I think the chauffeur would be allowed, right? Because he is a domestic servant.
No, you're right. It's rubbish.
Yeah. And then they released White Tiger in the middle of all this. It was even more chaos. It was like, oh, they won't kill us.
No, but so I have a slightly different theory, which I've mentioned before, which is governments of the world don't want to take the responsibility. So what they do is put it back on the citizen and say, everything is your fault. All right. So yeah. You figure it out. You guys in that fucking society, you had a party for 20 people and because of you, it's gone everywhere. It's not us. So you deserve a lockdown.
I have a great thought on this. Like, every time you go around Bombay, you'll see all the BMC posters with, like, people who are common and they write me jawabdar. Have you seen those? Like, me jawabdar, which in Marathi means I'm responsible. Mm-hmm. As simple as that. They're like, you're responsible. You're the one. Rickshaw guy is responsible. Driver is responsible. Delivery guy is responsible. We are not responsible. That's literally what it translates to in Marathi. It's hilarious.
Like, and you didn't listen. You didn't listen. Fuck? Nobody's going out of the way to get it. Don't talk rubbish. Just focus on the vaccine. Mm-hmm. Focus on the stronger in the community getting it and letting the immunity go through. And keep also the weaker ones away.
There are enough people who listened also and still got it. So what's the point of listening?
There is no magic bullet over here. You can get it. Anybody can get it.
Exactly. And nobody knows who has it.
No, you never know who has it. You never know who's going to get it. All that is there. But see, again, here's the thing, right? You have to...
Sorry, but my building vigilante, not mine, the next building vigilante, his family got it. And Orthodox is unbelievable. It's unbelievable, the irony. I mean, it's almost exactly how Silver is reacting. It's just... The guy's lecturing everybody all the time and then they get it.
But it can happen to anybody. It can happen to absolutely anybody at any point in time. That doesn't mean that you don't do the other restrictions that are necessary, right? You do the stand 6 feet away
but
from
not
people.
To a paranoia,
you do the
not
mask.
Not where anxiety
has
taken over your life. Not where you become like a racist or prejudiced person who points fingers to validate your existence. But it comes to a point where we are just living like zombies.
But that's just
my
point.
There's got to be a line in the sand saying, boss, enough.
But Cyrus, that's my point, right? That's why you have to stop down or you have to kind of really oppose nonsense because there are real things that need to be done. Wearing a mask is massively effective and we should be wearing masks. To not wear a mask is foolish. It's stupid. It's dumb, right? You should wear a mask. To not gather in big groups, right? And I mean, like, you know, this quote-unquote lockdown that we're under right now is extremely strict and I wish that we didn't have to have something strict. But dude, I know so many people who are having 20 people parties over the last couple of months. So many people I know having parties. Right. And I mean, like, you know, you do that. Okay. I'll tell you, this stuff is weird in how it spreads, right? One person doesn't know they have the virus. They hang out with somebody, that person gets it. That person doesn't know that that person had the virus. So she has no idea that she has the virus. She meets 10 people, 4 people get down with the virus from there. This stuff spreads really, really simply, really easily.
Fair enough. But you allow 1,000 people for election campaigning.
No, you don't. You shut that shit down.
You allow Kumela. No, I'm saying they have.
You allow
the Kumela, all right? All these things are going on. So at the same point, they're pointing fingers at the citizens as Zimedari Aapka hai, as he explained on every hoarding, all right? But wherever it's convenient, they've been able to, through political, what's the right word? Populist
Latmar
reasons.
Holi happened, in Mathura. Yeah. Like, they were doing Latmar Holi, which was like 20,000 plus people.
Exactly.
And that is obviously like people from all over the country go there. And they go back to their respective cities and towns taking the virus with them.
But you have to shut that stuff down. See, that's the stuff that has to be shut down, and that's the stuff that we need to talk about, right?
What is the point of the smaller things where each building, then all they do what they can, finally. But when you have one outbreak somewhere else, which is slightly bigger, it just negates everything else. I agree what you're saying, but that doesn't mean you shouldn't do it. I just think the futility in this large group of people living in this country that some idiot will do an idiotic thing and things will spread is massive, let's be honest.
But
so
just
let's
think, but just
from last March
to
now,
Sorry, Naveen.
There have been like an entirely different shift in the tonality of COVID fighting. Is because like last year in March, we were like, let's wear a mask, wearing this together, we'll fight this together. This year, we're just pointing fingers. We're like, on Twitter, I was watching this guy, was like, all the hawkers and people who sleep on the streets of Colaba are the real problem. So Mumbai is tagging Mumbai police, like, take them out, okay? And now people on Twitter are tagging, going to his Instagram and taking photos of his with the cycling group, where there are all 20 of them without a mask at Marine Lines. So who's responsible? Is it the big people who have money but still won't wear a mask? Or the poor people who don't have a house and are forced to live like that, you know? So that's become the conversation piece on Twitter right now, at least.
But that's
finger pointing, and then it becomes class oriented and complex.
Even at my house right now, every day there's like some point or the other, my mom and dad will change, which is, you know, people
more massive, have problems. More massive vigilance towards the vaccine, for one, for what it's worth. He's saying only 25 per day. Maharashtra doesn't have enough. All these things should have been addressed. We should have massive mobile clinics like they had in Dubai, for example. And just get people, go to them if they aren't coming to you.
So,
go to them.
India has not been terrible about the vaccine. It's not been as good as we would like it to. It's not been terrible. I think we have the second most doses in the world out, right?
Yeah,
but that's because of our population.
Very high.
Look at the percentile.
The percentile is good, but we win every argument
with population.
The number of vaccine doses is not created as a percentage of population. It's created by a manufacturing process. So you have to create those actual numbers, right? So, I mean, like, you know, the fact that we've deployed more than every other country except for the US at this point is a pretty strong this, right? I think that means that there has been a rollout and there has been something that's been there. It's not 100% satisfactory by any means of the imagination, right?
Let's just look at Maharashtra. That's my point, right?
In Maharashtra, my point is simply that, right? That in Maharashtra, Karnataka, Delhi, right? These are the three spots which have the biggest problem. These are the spots where you need to deploy vaccine in massive numbers to these three spots, right? Other parts
it's
of the country.
Not just that. You have to make sure the vaccine is taken. That's another logistical argument. Because obviously, if you're coming to a hospital and finding only 20, 25 people, regardless that it's the hospital's policy, the point is that's wrong. If it's a real urgent situation, that's where we should be having more urgency. Yeah. Rather than the building vigilante going berserk from the top of the terrace, shouting and screaming at people and pointing fingers and causing fights.
No, but I think if they had more vaccine, then probably like, you know, 25 or 50 a day that they're doing at a hospital, they could probably increase that number, right? But they need more vaccine.
Huh? Me and Silvery can go out and give vaccines to people on the road, we'll just catch them and jab them.
So that's the other one they're trying to do, right? They're trying to make it so that even like private clinics can, like smaller private clinics. Yeah. Right now, it's hospitals that can do the vaccine.
They're scared to go with the corporate. One way to do it is the corporate and buildings way. Especially, I'm talking cities, Mumbai and Delhi. You can literally go that way, you know, because then you can literally go like a max graph and you pass it to all of these people if you have enough. But then the Garib situation comes up, which is what happens to people who are not accessible through this, who fall through.
That's why you need more vaccine provided in the city, right? See, let's be very clear about the city of Bombay. 250 rupees for a dose of the vaccine, which is what you're paying.
125.
You paid 125. I paid 250.
125. 250 for both me and Aisha.
I paid 250.
You went online. You went online, na? We canceled the online and went yesterday. I had nothing to do because you refused to do a podcast with me. I had nothing to do. So after masturbating, I said, what do I do next? So I did it again. And then I went straight to the hospital. My hands are clean. You can check. She said, I don't want to check. But a very interesting conversation. Each one was nicer than the other. Huh?
There was a sample. Did you take a sample along to the vaccination?
I did.
In
just
case
to make
someone
their day.
Guys for later.
Yeah, they said they'd give me the inoculation and another body part. So I had to be worried. But now, see, we lost our train of thought because you're a stupid juvenile conversation from time to time that comes up.
You missed that. You missed that. Honestly.
I miss that. I miss that a lot. Don't worry. Amit is beautiful. Amit is like almost like my family member now. You know, they just ignore me, but without being disrespectful. So I say something and he just goes back to his point seamlessly. He's one of the few times when we've lost our train of thought. Because it's gone here and there with everyone. And I think Silvery is very nice. As long as you're older, he shows fake respect. It's all good. No. Yeah.
It's all real respect, Cyrus. Love you.
Yeah, right.
How does Silvery happen? What does Silvery have?
Oh boy, okay.
I'll tell you one later.
We need, you know what we need? We need like a recording of how did Silvery happen, the story. And then every time somebody asks, ding, ding, ding.
You cut to that, it's a 30-second promo explaining everything. Hi, I'm Silvery. This is what happened as fast as you can go.
No, in the comedy scene, Antariksha has this reputation of being the most positive and enthu cutlet of all comics. Like, we're all like, usually depressed about after, even if after a bad show, nobody turns up. Antariksha is like, yeah, man, let's do the show, man. Yeah, two people, yes, let's do the show, man. I'm like, okay, Antariksha, come.
Theory of relativity. his podcast experience is so crappy that he loves going back.
No.
He feels happy. And may I say gay. Naveen.
Yeah.
Tell us some gossip, no?
What gossip you want?
Which IS or IPS
officer? By the way, Kunal Kamra is retiring from comedy. That's the gossip you want. He's doing like an entire month of shows and then like stopping comedy for a bit.
So not retiring.
That's called a hiatus or sabbatical.
No, he's like he's taking like a proper break, like Modi did in a cave with a fan. So that's
okay.
What he'll do.
Okay.
All right. How many days will he be in this cave?
So he's doing the entire month of May. Like every day in May, he'll perform and record, and then he'll retire. He's saying. I also watched Munawar live recently in Pune.
You should say alive more than live.
Yeah.
Munawar alive.
Why that's a great. I kept that as my show's name, anyways. But he had bouncers and all at the comedy show, like big guys. And I'm like, this was hilarious to watch because there's three of them. Three bouncers for the entirety of BJP is not going to work. You know what I'm saying?
So yeah. Three bouncers are which one is a card carrying member of the RSS. Just remember that. It'll be like, yeah, turn on the guy.
But what's sad about the whole thing is that the people who were with him, like Nalin Yadav, Edwin Antony, who also went to jail.
Are they still in?
Yeah.
No, they got out, but Nalin Yadav, for example, has no income right now. His family disowned him, and he's working as a laborer for 200 rupees per day. So, you know,
kidding,
that's what
right?
No, this is serious. I'm serious about this. It's actually happening. So, while in the wake of all this, Munawar got the fame and his shows are sold out right now.
Hey, don't blame Munawar. It's not like
I'm saying there's disparity in this. It's clear. Yeah. Even Nalin is a comic. It's from Indore only, but now he's been forced to work menial jobs to survive, while back in
Bombay, the other guy.
Sorry?
The other guy, his third name?
Edwin Antony.
Huh.
Yeah. There's no use of him right now. I think he stopped comedy altogether. He's so scared.
Should we observe 2 minutes of silence?
We should. Not for him, but for comedy.
For comedy. Okay. Then 3 minutes for comedy. Give it some more time.
Yeah.
There's a comment which has just come in. It says, Sachin Jangam has said that, read this on Live Mint website right now. Kunal Kamra and his family are COVID positive.
Yeah, they are. Mom and dad was positive and he also is positive.
Oh God. I thought it would be like a joke where he says I'm positive about COVID or something. I'm waiting for that, but perhaps it's sensitive. So let's hope they're okay.
Anyway, let's get to some Maharashtra, some Mumbai news. Mumbai, some lockdown news. BMC announced some fresh set of restrictions. And as part of those restrictions, Swiggy and Zomato are also shut after 8 p.m. from 8 p.m. to 7 a.m.
What do you do?
Which is
I think that's just restaurants are shut at 8 p.m., which is fucking bullshit. But I mean, it is what it is, I guess. It's ridiculous. I don't understand the logic on this, right? I mean, why are you stopping food delivery at 8 p.m.?
Yeah, exactly.
So basically, you're allowed to order food for lunch and not allowed to order food for dinner. So that
you have to order dinner at lunch.
Yeah. So there's basically no COVID at lunch. There's only COVID for dinner.
It only comes out at nighttime.
When they do this lockdown with a little bit of left-right angles open and all that, you're not going to please everyone. I accept that.
Yeah.
But my whole point is, it just doesn't make sense to me. I feel it's too much effort going into this lockdown and marshalling the streets and all, and not enough on the other side of how to deal with COVID, which is the vaccine, which we discussed, Amit, including yourself, right at the beginning, that, you know, then we'll go hammer and tong and all that. I just feel that urgency hasn't happened.
No, it's just not.
I didn't feel that. I didn't feel people were like, okay, let's get into this place quickly. Let's get it done. You know that your work has been cancelled for the week. Everybody suddenly had the week off. Most people rather. And then come there and get it done.
It's a question of doses now. I mean, how many doses do you have?
Yes. So the logistical nightmare is not our problem. That is the problem of that's why we have a government.
Yeah.
They have to be accountable for this. I demand accountability. I'm even wearing a suit and a red tie. I'm like that guy whose name I cannot mention. He doesn't need a jab. He needs a jab. Okay, again, we got lost. Amit, bring us back to reality.
So, as part of these BMC lockdowns, Swiggy and Zomato are already shut. The BMC has announced some very specific rules for Mumbai only, in addition to all the restrictions that the Maharashtra government has put to Maharashtra anyway. So, the BMC has announced that beaches will be shut till April 30th. So, that's firstly. I haven't been to a beach for a while, so that's I'm not.
There goes
mind
a
that.
Mumbai summer, yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
goes Mumbai summer.
Yeah.
What about that guy with the show, Son of a Beach? He's finished.
Oh, nicely done.
When we start eating our own, it's over.
But it does make sense that the BMC did lock down the beaches, because if you saw photos recently, the beaches have been packed as hell.
I'll give you the date. Okay, we had started shooting that film in October. It was the end of October when they announced that you can open the beaches. So the Aksa Beach, one of the beaches at Mud Island where the poor people shoot, like me, we tried to get out at 6:37 in the evening, and it was the first day of that beach being open. Amit, I kid you not, you can ask all the other actors in that show. Nobody cleared Malad for 1 hour 40 minutes.
Ma'am,
just that getting out of Madhavi. It was unbelievable the way that, and then finally they're telling us, uska pehla din hai bache, 8 mahine ke baad, with the kids, forget mask. Mask was gone. You're all over the place, kids in your hand, all that crossing the road. It was just packed. On a Sunday, a beach in Mumbai, it can, I mean, it's, COVID was just thinking, oh, let's go here.
It's as good as Kumbh Mela, like at Juhu on a Sunday evening. It's horrible.
Don't bring down the Kumbh Mela, Naveen. That's a record population and includes foreigners. So where it can take COVID globally is, this is India at its best.
Yeah.
You can get, in 15 minutes, you can go to Israel, Russia, Germany again, you know, all the countries that are recovering, like England, boom, back there.
Our greatest export is diseases.
Well, they'll die happy if they've taken enough, you know.
So I'm watching all these old photos of like Goa and all from like the Vice archives. It was quite amazing to look at. Before like people found Goa and made it horrible. Like, I really wish like in the recent months, I've been thinking of going to a beach myself. Like that's the one thing, like, you know, summertime, we'll go out of your town and go to like a Gokarna.
You know who owned his own beach? Vijay Mallya.
Yeah.
He had a section of a beach in Goa to himself.
I know. Even these Mahindra people have, no? They have a whole like...
That's another experience altogether. You have a little, because technically you shouldn't have, because it's all public coast property and all that, but they have managed and figured out how to. That's a lovely feeling.
Well, you can have beachfront property in India, I think. I don't think it's all...
there are ways to walk around it.
Yeah.
The ways to work around it has to not be a security hazard. More importantly, you have to have lots of money and influence.
Well, of course. I think that's the case for any, if you want to own a house, an independent structure, you have to have lots of money and influence. Like this guy, no? We just sold a 1,000 crore rupee house just got sold, no?
Somebody's working hard. Everyone's talking about no work, that young Naleen Yadav has gone back to labor, things like that. And somebody spends 1,000 crores on a house.
It was insane when I heard about it, right? 1,000 crores for this. But again, it's a big property, I guess.
But so, you know, his point, Naveen's point is superbly made. I'll tell you why. Because there's a certain, I think the English word language doesn't have a word to equate with sukoon. But if you want that sort of real peace of mind and tranquility, if you have a little area for yourself in times like this, you will be so, so grateful. You don't have to have acres. Just a small little patch.
Where like your really, Alibag house?
I don't own anything. Please let everyone know that I work for the government. I'm with RAW, but like, pronounce it Rav.
This is like something what Ron Swanson would say in Parks and Recreation. No, I have no property.
Growing up, nobody should know this. English poets would talk about how a slice of land would be England anywhere they were, you know, sort of that patriotic thing about, you know, you get a piece of land anywhere in colonial world and it would still remind you of England. But there's something in that, not the reminding of England and the jingoism attached to that. I'm talking about the fact that you have that area where you can be king again, because it just takes away your murdness when you're just standing there behind gates and all that. And just to have a little patch to yourself, it's a little while, you're a little king in a little pond, but what the hell, it's something. So I think those who can afford it, it's not always about money, figure out a way to find a little patch for yourself. It doesn't have to be huge. Mm. We're Indians. We're not going to get huge stuff, except the 1,000 crore house guy. Who's he?
Damani, DMart guy.
Yeah, the guy. Would, yeah.
Why did I even ask?
You didn't hear about the DMart
CEO's name is Navil Narona. Only one difference. Like, there's an N in my name and there's an L in his name. And that's all the difference. Like, he's rich and I'm not. That's the difference. Probably same bloodline also. I don't know.
Think about a guy called Vijay Ambani. No relation. What is his life like? Everywhere he goes, Ambani.
I think all of them legally change their surname only.
I can imagine, because people ask him for loans. But I'm many.
Speaking of surnames, you think people change their surnames ever? What if someone has a surname like Trump?
Bin Laden's surname is not Trump, right? Like he's got a different surname.
Trump is fairly common, so you may not have to.
No, Trump is not a common surname. Trump is a made-up surname.
German descent.
His actual surname is Drumpf, D-R-U-M-P-F.
Oh, yeah.
And then from that, his father changed it to Trump.
Yeah.
Right, like a Trump card.
And his great-grandfather in 1939 was in Poland in the first invasion.
Yeah. Right. So that's another last name, which I think if you have that last name, you change it, right?
That's what Hitler did. He kept the mother's surname.
Well, So there was actually a really funny episode of the show called Happy Endings, was it? Yeah, Happy Endings.
You mean My Weekend in Bangkok?
Similar name, but
more than one
piece of land, not a piece of
Happy Endings. Sense.
But the plot of it was that basically one of these girls dates a guy named whose last name is Hitler. And he's like, I'm not related to that Hitler. My family has been in the U.S. for like, you know, 150 years.
And they didn't change the name.
And he's like, no, we're very proud of our last name. We're very proud to be Hitler.
Why?
It's hilarious.
Are you
going to
outmaneuver
right?
that guy's achievements? Or, you know,
it's hilarious because this girl is Jewish. And then, like, you know, she starts crushing on this guy. So she starts, like, you know, drawing in her diary, my Mrs. Penny Hitler and stuff like that.
Is it made up or is it for real?
No, it's a joke. It's a sitcom, dude.
Oh, it's a sitcom.
Even Ricky Gervais has a bit now where he's like, you don't see a lot of Adolf running around nowadays, you know? Like, they don't name the children
Adolf anymore.
Did you
know the founder?
Oh, they take out the A and Adolf Lundgren. They keep the dolls without the A. Nobody wants an Adolf word said in public.
But then he has Lundgren in the second part. So, like, you know, as Indians, we laugh at both of them. Ooh. You know what I'm saying?
Heterosexual.
Like he had sex with Hulk.
Wait, but I didn't know Dolph Lundgren is actually Adolf Lundgren.
Come on.
Probably God. Wasn't. He was that probably born though, after World War II. But I mean, like, it is this, no?
It's a weird name.
There's
Dolph.
No way Dolph is not a Dolph. Okay? It's a Dolph.
But I think it's Dolph.
It's the same general area. Okay? The Teutonic area. This is the name.
Dolphin Lundgren, guys.
I think it's actually Dolphin. Yeah. His actual name is, I think, Dolphin Lundgren.
Oh, okay.
Fair enough.
Just call him
Dolphin. You're the positive comedian, right? Whatever happens.
What? Yeah.
His spark is sinking.
Give him the benefit of the doubt. Yeah.
There remember when Dolph Lundgren played He-Man? Did you remember that movie? He was He-Man.
I remember him in Rocky 3.
It was Dolph Lundgren.
Of course.
Rocky 3 is okay. Rocky 4, actually.
Rocky 4.
Three, he defeats the other guy. And 4, he has to then fight with him.
Yeah, no, he's Ivan Drago. No, it's that right. 4 only. He's in 4
Puka
only.
Beginning, he beats up Creed.
Silvery, let's walk out. Now, these two bloody encyclopedias are going to go on about which Rocky is right for the next 45 minutes.
I know all the Rockies.
Saving India from COVID to which Rocky is right.
Listen, I've seen all the Rockies multiple times. Gopal also I know them all. Even the latest one, I've seen more than once.
Creed is good.
Yeah.
Gopal, let's do a test with someone who works in films more than any of us.
Okay.
And shows. Gopal, how many Rockies are there total? Rockies?
Not in Ludhiana, like in...
Yeah, not Rocky Mountains, yeah.
Rocky film.
Rocky film, Sylvester Stallone. Oh. Isn't that total?
6, 7?
This is the Uttarakhand answer.
It's not wrong, actually. There's 5 main
seven.
Ones and 2 new ones.
Seven, two creeds. Two creeds and two...
Where is the coach? Not bad.
Not bad.
Not bad. Okay. And
so, Sanjay Dutt's first movie was called Rocky.
Oh, that's true.
Sanjay Dutt. Rocky Mera Naam.
Rocky Mera Naam, yeah.
No, Rocky. Just
the song is Rocky Mera Naam. Title track.
Song is Rocky Mera
Naam. Arey, I've danced to it.
Rocky Mera Naam. Rocky Mera Naam.
Okay, let's just take a quick break and then come back. And we'll adjust this Bollywood-Hollywood trivia that we're doing in a second.
It's a change from Corona for a change. We have some happy things also.
No. There's no happiness.
One last thing
until
to talk about.
Until the building vigilantes are shot, I can't wait for it to end. I want to go again. See, right now, you can't say anything because they're sort of right most of the time. But once it ends, we do stand up only on them. Naveen, I'll join you. Oh, the worst WhatsApp messages, the things they say.
The lack of consciousness about how classist they are sometimes.
Yeah.
That's the thing that's really come to the fore, right? That
exactly
people don't
what you said.
Realize just how aggressively kind of discriminatory they are towards poorer people. I'm amazed.
No, they didn't even notice it. They just sent all the employees to walk the roads to the world's North India and that's it. Lock the gates. Those gates are so ugly to see them locked. You know, I see them locked, I get angry. It's like, you know, only us rich people will stay in and save our little small families who nobody cares about anyway. And all these poor guys have nowhere to go. Not a plan. They just send them off. That's it. It's like the gates are locked. Do not come in.
Yeah. My own private zoo. And I own it.
I had to fight for my newspapers. I want to read my print newspapers. No. Print newspaper will lead to an epidemic. After it was also proven that there's really not much happening to touch.
Also, newspapers are among the most sterile things that exist. Like, you know, they actually say that if you need to do emergency surgery and you need bandages, use the inside pages of newspapers. They're super sterile.
And let me tell you, I use them also for potty. Not mine. Mine yet. But the doggies. So they are doing, they're always used properly. They're recycled everywhere. I choose my artist for the potty. There are names that feature in the paper. So who's the guy for today to pick up the potty?
Exactly.
Like is it a member of parliament? Is it a scientist?
So I had an issue as a child where I couldn't squat because I was too chubby as a child also. So I'd always fall backwards. I couldn't squat as a child because
couldn't sit on the pot.
We didn't have a pot. We were born in a chawl. So like I had to like go to a community
bathroom. Indian style,
yeah.
So how did you fall back? You'll die.
I didn't die,
but it's a mess.
It's an open hole. We'll never see Naveen again.
It flushed in the toilet. No, I just fell back on my own poop.
Okay, wait, Cyrus, you've never used it in a toilet.
Oh my God, I'm leaving the show. God, that's horrible.
This is classism, Cyrus. It's exactly what happened. Where do you think the people on the streets shat when they were walking back to North India? They were shitting on the newspapers only.
Think about the fact that if you were born 20 years later, this would be on your Insta as a 10-year-old. Okay, off to the pot again. Horrible story.
Indian style is the best technically, okay? While pooping.
It is supposed to be the best for achieving the goal.
Yeah.
But I find it very hard to watch your phone and read things and all, which my generation had books and stuff.
Yeah.
Me and Amit would have magazines in our hands. And if you do that, you'll really go to the pot or the magazine.
Exactly. You can't waste an hour in the toilet in the Indian style. Yeah. But you can in America.
I used to do a radio show for a guy called Farhan Wadia who'd only call me on the pot. And I could hear everything. And he'd be giving me directions about what the show would be, that day, and who's coming and all, similar to the podcast. But what's the problem? All the different natural things, that kind of thing.
That's kind of disgusting.
Well, you get used to it, Amit.
I guess you do, but that doesn't mean that it's not disgusting.
One man's disgusting is another man's. I mean, like we discussed once in Arabia, you can burp after a meal and that's supposed to be a great thing. Kunal burps all the time. I'm offended, horrified. Now my daughter started copying him. So they eat and burp while
That's the footage we need on the foodie show. You know, we never get to see that side. We just see him eating, but the after effects is what
he burps. He's a burper. He's horrible. It's embarrassing with his phone ringing all the time and the burping. I mean, it's just not a good person to have in public. Yeah, he's the only one with the mask on. The guy who's had two jabs, fully safe. He's got the mask on, but the rest of us can die, as you can see. Gopal will be killed soon, then Mohit will be killed after that. There you can see. I don't know what you're talking about. Yeah, what a team, no? I think by now we're working with Shah Rukh and Salman. No, still Mohit and Gopal.
The eye of Shah Rukh and Salman.
Of course, they are thinking the same.
So,
what is the next topic?
That's the one last thing about this. We have finished this BMC new restrictions and all. One more rule that BMC has put in place during this lockdown thing is that every housing society which has five or more cases, COVID cases in them, will be declared a micro containment zone, and a police officer will be deployed and kept stationed outside the gate of that society.
Will he walk my dogs?
I don't know.
He would have to leave his post now to do that.
Yeah.
I've seen his post when he walks my dog. They don't want me to walk.
That's true. Yeah.
I guess that's probably true.
Okay.
We're just making assumptions for the police that they will walk dogs, but okay, sure. Why not?
What the hell? They want to
tell you about how
the police should help dog walk, not hinder. I can go around with a stick and scream at people to go get back inside the building. But what about helping? Go and get my groceries, walk my dogs, spot me when I'm benching. I have no one. Come on. What the hell?
But
Where are they now?
But I don't think that when they're doing these as containment zones, that means that they're not allowing people to exit the building. I think that people are still moving.
So, Amit, if you remember, in our area, hanging guns proper, you have seen a few of them in April, May. So it wasn't about exiting the building, but they're keeping an eye on the main cases.
On what's going in and out. Yeah, exactly.
So they should not leave. So it's more that. Correct. But I don't know the new rules now. They might just say, everybody stay home.
No, I don't think that's the case. Because again, I know a couple of buildings which have been kind of locked down like this. And it's not as if nobody is leaving the building at all, right? I mean, like, you know, uninfected people or unaffected people are able to come in and out every when they need to. Again, during, I guess,
they put a banner outside. This is a cold area now. And in our building, the ground floor house is the first one that got affected. So they took them to the quarantine center because once you enter, their house is the first. So everybody who passes the building will end up like getting infected by them. So they took
After your pot story, I'm not able to take that visual out of my head. So whatever you're saying, I'm just seeing you squatting and falling.
I'm squatting and doing this also right now.
That's Naveen.
Hello, Naveen.
Long time, man. That's not a bank robber. That's actually Kunal. And he's wearing
double jab.
He's wearing my underwear. See, look at his face. It's a thong. He's at the double gym.
It is not Sanjay's underwear. There'll be holes in it.
How do you know?
That's true. You can't say no to that.
There you go. Yeah, double jam, Salah. Yeah.
All right, shall we go to AMS?
Let's go to
AMS. Yes, let's go to AMS.
All right. So we have a lot of messages for Naveen. Say, welcome back, Naveen. Good to see you again, Naveen. Where were you for so long, Naveen? So Naveen, what have you been up to and what's coming up for you, man?
So after I left IBM, I did 2 tours of India. I was very happy with the touring and then lockdown happened. So then
Naveen, someone saying hi to you. Just say hello. He's all the way from the south.
hello, man. How are you?
Yeah, standing for Lexan.
Yeah.
Starting with election.
Yeah.
Okay. That's ELE, not ERE.
I was like, what the fuck?
Sorry, Naveen. Okay. Back to you.
Sorry, Naveen. Yeah.
No, so that's what, like, I've been doing comedy and then, not much has happened. I've moved in with my partner in Khar now. So I have 3 cats and I have a beautiful house and I'm happy.
So you got some pussy?
And you're releasing?
Multiple pussies I have. Yeah.
And you're releasing a video, I think, today or tomorrow.
It's a little bit of the show.
Tomorrow I'm dropping a new video after ages. That's been a thing. We shot in January when the lockdown opened.
Hey bro, I want to ask you, you move in with your partner in this archaic world that we live in. Nobody has a problem with your 2 roommates.
So yeah, so we lived in a different apartment for 2 years, which was very problematic because they were always like, what's happening? Kaun hai, log kya hai, log, and all that. And it would harass us a lot, the kids and everything. Like the people were interested in what we are doing basically. But now in the new building, we hung a rainbow flag outside our house and we said we are queer. And we are partners and we don't give a fuck anymore.
And they're cool?
Yeah, they're very cool. Like all the ladies and all, they're like, how's your partner?
Your building is much better than mine.
It is,
I wouldn't know about the homosexual angle, but they're so... Oh, don't even...
I mean, even my landlord was like, just close the door when you're doing it. That's all. Like, don't be open. No policy.
Why were you opening your door and doing it, Naveen?
It's a joke. It's a joke.
No, what's the joke with the landlord? Why does he have to say that? Well, what is he... Being an exhibitionist got nothing to do with your gender preference.
I don't think he meant the sex part.
Fuck. Just because he's gay doesn't mean he's got all these other things going for him. He must be the shyest fuck in the whole world. Just look at the bigotness of our thinking. The moron is saying, oh, keep your door shut. He won't say no. It's got nothing to do with the gender-specific sexual action.
Naveen likes his landlord. It seems like Naveen likes his landlord.
Yeah, I like him. It's very cool.
That's a stupid question.
But I just also missed this. I also missed what Cyrus Gohan tells him. He has no idea about it.
Well, look at the logic. What a moron says that. Boss, I'm very liberal. Yeah, I have no problem, but one karke karo. That sounds too hypocritical, firstly. Come on.
That's hilarious.
Oh, God. What if they hang up without pants and, you know, sir, here's the rent? What's going on? That's not a bad idea, actually. Lower the rent.
Very clean building. Plus, our building is very pro animal support. Like, there are a lot of dogs who are strays, who are fed by the people, cats, and generally, like, there are very warm people.
Your building is sounding a very evolved and good building. It's so far away from my building, I can't tell you.
It's mainly Jaibhim society, you know, or a Jaibhim society, like mainly predominantly Dalit people. So, they're very kind in general because they have seen hardships, so they understand other people.
This is reverse racism. Now you're insinuating the others are not.
No, I'm just saying that they understand the plight of people who are coming from the marginalized or the minority background. So they're not.
It's the Angela Merkel philosophy. The oppressed understand oppression.
Yes. Yeah. That's for sure.
And hence she's more open to, because from coming from East Germany, more open to immigrants. While anyone born in, say, West Germany is like, who are these brown people? Why are they here? And why do they have mustaches? I can't remember what they would say exactly. I'm just, you know, making this up. Germany, I love you. I love Germany. I'm a big German fan. I won't take all that back. Really love that country. Wish I could speak German.
How about
my people.
Change your child's name to Hitler now?
Just because everything is not bad. There's also Beethoven, man. Come on, you can't just put it all down to friggin' Hitler. There's FC Bayern Munich, and you know, I mean, there's so many good stuff.
All the car companies, the German cars.
They're all the German cars. Yeah, he's right.
Yeah.
And all the beautiful Fräuleins, some of whom will be my age now.
Beer,
Oktoberfest.
Yes.
Those gardens, those beer gardens of those. Have you guys have ever been there? It's so nice.
Yeah, play.
Sausages too. Yeah, well, yeah. I mean, like, not just for you. Yes.
And I'm not a sausage man.
not that way.
I must say,
it generally like a bratwurst is my favorite thing.
Frankfurt. I mean, you have to.
Comes with the Frank. Anyways,
okay, let's.
I'm not there.
But my video is coming tomorrow, guys. Please watch it.
Yes.
Okay.
Absolutely.
What is the video about?
It's about censorship on Indian TV. So I'm very happy with that. Yeah.
Oof. Cool. You're happy with the censorship or the video?
No, the video, how it turned out. Censorship, no one cares really. We all have like now on Netflix, Hotstar, all that to watch.
Now, whether they ban the F word or not, who cares? It's locking up in your building with the cops standing outside. It's like, oh no. Oh, Silvery, I got 5 minutes.
Next one comes in from Michael Ribeiro. He says, hi, Cyrus. And guests, Why do you think people stand right next to you in a toilet when there are many vacant pots, which makes it awkward for you?
For me, it's a real personal issue. Because when I first did my bad stand-ups, you know, it's not like once. And yeah. I use public urinals outside the Oval. I used to use it all the time because we didn't have a toilet for a long time. Now we don't again. And so I've been using them all over India, not just in Mumbai. I just can't get it. They're just Indian men always cling. If it's an empty urinal, they still cling. They never keep space. And not only that, now with the mobile phone, they have conversations. Their elbows are in your face. They're really loud. You know, they're peeing all over the place. Their pee hits your foot. You know, this is where the government should step in, not COVID. This is where they can do things correctly. From childhood, you should be trained that if someone is peeing, give them a little space. Don't stand right next to them. It's not like he's going to help you pee, which is not a state.
Like a helping hand, just in case you don't find it.
And you know, you give them the stare of the elite who are not used to people coming close, and they don't get it. They just look through the stare. The stare means nothing to them. It's, I'm going to pee. I don't care about all these permutations and conditions in your head. I just want to pee. He doesn't care where, how, what. So much booty part of
post-COVID, they should have at least understood, right? Like, there are in Bangalore, I was in Bangalore in early Feb, and they had like these marked off like urinals, like slabs, and then there's a tape, okay, where they've put an X, so you can't use this one.
Even in Mumbai,
dude came, so I'm peeing, one more guy's peeing in the other thing. He came and took the tape out and started peeing over there because he's
in the Calcutta airport. The guy came and peed on the tape right next to me, okay? And this happened recently, so you don't even
start. That's a target mark. I have to pee on that. The extra
I think if you want to save yourself from COVID, you have to pee without using hands somehow. This has got to be taught to kids from early childhood. Take it out on your own without using hands. It's got to work itself through, and then it's sort of got to pee, and then it's got to sort of work itself back. And your hands.
But what about women?
I can help.
They still have to like hover on the seats, right?
No, maybe I Silvery and me on our free time we can do what is necessary for the society to flourish.
Sure.
Look at Amit's face.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
We had so much toilet conversation between your potty and my dog's potty, and this. I mean, this whole show has gone down the toilet. Oof! Ouch. Yeah.
But wait, Naveen, you said someone came and removed the cross from the middle urinal.
They pull it out and pee.
Yeah, like no, that's fine. No, but when you go to a public washroom, do you not try and touch as little stuff in a public toilet as possible? So I would never remove.
Do that, and there's 25% who don't have a problem because they need to pee, and there's no space. The only space is that X guy. Take out the X.
And if one out of four people are so problematic, then.
Yeah, I'm giving you a figure that from my head. Who knows? Maybe
more. That's true. That probably makes sense. Yeah. All right. Next one comes in from Rohan.
Go back to our old civilization and pee on the road and don't get into the humans. The old days. You stop your car, you let it out, you fire, nobody's around. If someone can tell Kunal not to face the highway and pee, you should always face the other. That's so embarrassing. People on there, you know. That fat guy in the food thing. Naveen, sorry. Right. We get it out of this whole, you know, penis envy thing.
Next one comes in from Rohan Dadina. The question is, hey, Fantastic Four, I have a question for all of you. Do you hate it when you are served tea/coffee with excessive milk and it looks and tastes like shit? No other words to describe it.
Coffee with milk.
I don't drink tea or coffee.
With excessive milk.
Mentioning coffee,
is fine, I think.
The problem is that they generally ask you wherever you go, if it's a guest or whatever, a non-paid one. With paid one, you'll tell him yourself that you want so much milk or so much sugar or whatever, right? Isn't that the way it's done? So this can only happen if they suddenly surprise you with tea or coffee, or if it's ready-made in a big box.
It's ready-made. Now, like a lot of offices you go to, it's ready-made. So my
then you're screwed.
So I mean, even a drop of milk in coffee ruins it in my mind, right? I think like coffee is only to be drunk black, whether it's cold, whether it's hot, whatever it is. I mean, like, you know, you want the taste of coffee.
Black coffee matters.
Black coffee matters. 100% matters. It's the only thing that matters. I don't drink it. If somebody offers me like that Nescafe ka mithai in a cup, I don't drink that stuff.
Yeah,
I love that shit, dude. But I mean, not too much milk, but I like milk and coffee together.
I can't stand it. I can't stand it in coffee. I like Indian chai, which is not so bad. I don't drink it that regularly, but that's almost always made like on a very standard recipe in India, right? I mean, like milk and tea is always like half and half water, milk half. It's very standard.
No, and so in Mangalore, where my native land is, they put more water.
Okay.
It just ruins it even worse because they don't even boil it as much. So they put water, some milk, and give it one boil, and they're done. So basically,
taste. But you know, tap that across India is initially done because to save milk, not for taste. That's why yeah, it was, so the idea came up all across India.
It varies from like area to area. So in Himachal and all, the Pahadi chai is much stronger in comparison because they're more colder there. As compared to South India, where it's like it's more warmer, so they just have to like have tea or beverage to get started with the day and not really to like get them into kickstart mode. So I would never take the tea over there. It's like I make my own tea if I go to my native land. It's crazy.
But at my age now, 40 something, if I don't like food that's given to me, I've stopped respecting people too much. I just say, look, I'm going to eat it.
I
think it's more disrespectful to pretend to like it. Hurt their feelings. Forget it.
What I've kind of come to is like I will try stuff even if it doesn't look appetizing if I've never eaten that kind of thing. But if I don't like it, I'll say no. I mean, I'm very comfortable saying no nowadays. That's not.
I'll say no even if I don't like the stuff. I don't like the person, or I don't like the ambience, or the AC is not on. They're not.
Well, that I say no. I'm sure we all say no for that kind of situation, right?
Yeah. Like, have you noticed waiters in the old days when we had restaurants who would clean? So you're eating and they just stand around. You know, I find that
really
irritating. Why is he still there?
I'll say this. The only place where I've ever had that be an issue is the most expensive restaurant I've ever been to in Bombay, relatively speaking, compared to the time. This was the Zodiac Grill at Taj. That's the only place where I ever felt that. Where I ever felt like, why are these people standing behind me?
See, the great ones... They're friendly. We're friendly. We're males alone. They're regular. They see you. So you build a little bond. Huh. And you chat. But the great ones, like say Grand Center, when we used to go Friday night drinking and all, they'll chat for just the right amount. And then they give you a space. They just know how to do it.
No,
so everybody's happy. And you all love each other. It's a nice tribe. But there are those who are just, they're just like that friend who never leaves your side all the time. Somewhere. So they just come and stand right there while you're eating.
That happens at the high end more than the low end or mid end, doesn't it?
Yeah, because in the low end, they're rushing around.
If you
go to Udupi and all that, and the guy's just so busy. He's got no time for you. Throws the food and runs off. Yeah. But you're right. But it's also to do with the fact that you bonded with these guys and now you know how to get rid of them.
That's always a problem at, I don't even know if I should mention that. There is a restaurant which serves food is based in Dadar, where the...
All restaurants serve food!
The owner of the restaurant has a tendency to come and sit with you for like 20 minutes.
Oh, he's famous. Suhas Auchard you're talking about.
Yes, I am. It's a nice restaurant. I really like the food. But, you know, it's a factor, man. I mean, like, so we don't go there as often as I would have otherwise. But, I mean, because, I mean, like, you don't want to talk to 20 minutes.
Yeah. But in America, the proprietors sometimes have the same thing. But I don't know. It depends on your friendship, right?
Yeah.
If you're very good friends, you're on the table.
I think it depends on the ability of the restaurant owner to, you know, read the table, right, to an extent.
Yeah.
You
can sit sometimes with some people, but not with all people. Yeah,
at all times, right? Just read this stuff a little bit, right? Because I mean, I remember this happened a couple of times where we were 10 people on the restaurant table and conversation developed into something serious all of a sudden. This was like a long time ago. Somebody was meeting girls to get married, and it turned into a conversation about this stuff, and that was like a serious conversation. And this guy came and sat for 20 minutes in the middle of that.
And also,
the
other dynamic is in your group of, say, 4 or 5 people, one or two people are not comfortable with that person.
Yeah.
Friendship is with you or the other person. So then they start feeling irritated because they're just waiting for the guy to go and they're not comfortable to talk. So the whole social dynamics is very complex. So we are appeal to all famous waiters and owners, 2 minutes, 30 seconds, and off you go.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, fair? Agreed. Unless you're friends. Right, I have a lot of restaurant owner friends, and I mean, like, you know, if I
go to the place, then they are friends first, and the restaurant is second. That's
exactly,
different.
Yeah.
But I'm telling you, if Naveen or Silvery come while I'm eating, I would rather they just, message later. Honestly, is it okay, Silvery?
I'll just sit away from you, I'll be like, this is my food, and the bill he'll take care of. That's all I do. Okay.
You really think that's going to happen? You don't know me at all, my brother.
Do you think that you would be able to finish your food before Cyrus eats, pays his bill, and leaves?
The only one cheaper than me in MTV was Cyrus Saukar. Who is actually a crook and a criminal. I'm borderline criminal. He's an actual criminal. That's the only one worse than me because he would take money from the spot to pay his cab and that money would not go back. And the spot
and
right
that's
now
that character he had in Rang De Basanti also. Do you know that? Like in Rang De Basanti, he goes around asking for money and cigarettes and all.
But there's a reason why, no? Because he said, play yourself. Just play yourself.
Yeah. So for me, the favorite part of a restaurant thing is like if I know them, like if I'm going to a restaurant, like you know, when you walk in and the cashier is sitting over there, he does this to you and you do this to him. That's the best. Like they know you that you're here, and the waiter also does this, and this is the Bombay style. Okay, everybody does this.
ODPs are the best. Regular places, you know, the Mangalorean guys and all, they just do it the best because they give you the right amount of respect and familiarity for you to feel comfortable, but they never cross that line, ever. Okay, guys, speaking of crossing that line, I'm going to go and work with Gopal and Kunal, both who are unheard people who can't read scripts, and also I'll just go and work with them.
All right.
And Silvery, now that I'm stuck tomorrow in another strange shoot, we have to manage from wherever.
Yes, we will manage.
We have refused to work on Tuesday.
Yes.
Okay.
Wait, tomorrow we have a big guest.
Ratna Patak.
Yes, we have a big guest.
So please
check. Run an ad with her.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yes. Yeah. And please tune in, guys, tomorrow.
You're in the studio only, right? Tomorrow?
I'm in a studio in Worli, my friend's studio, which we'll be using because of these rules for that other pilot that we're trying to do.
Okay. All right. Cool.
Yeah.
Cool.
So if you want to come there or anybody wants to come there with a
paraphernalia. No, we need to figure out the internet pieces. Yeah, that's what I was worried about a little bit.
No, but he says that the Wi-Fi is okay. I already spoke to him. But okay. I don't know, guys. If that happens and then I don't know what to do. Like, you know.
All right. Cool. We can talk about this later. We don't need Naveen's to talk about this while we're still live.
Naveen's video is coming out.
Naveen's video, yes.
Sex by the Beach.
Yeah. Which is tomorrow 12 p.m. Watch out.
And your YouTube channel
is Naveen's Arora, right? Called? What is it called?
Censorship on Indian TV. It'll be out
Censorship
tomorrow.
On Indian TV. Why am I repeating it?
It'll be a premiere on my thing with a trailer also. So go and watch. Set a reminder on my YouTube and you'll be able to catch the whole thing.
Yeah. And there are lots of naked girls throughout the entire show. And I'm in the beginning.
Yeah,
talking to camera.
Which is me only.
I've just killed the entire show.
No, I've actually done twerking in the video, so that's a good thing.
Hey, wow.
I'm twerking like Nicki Minaj.
Are you serious?
I just don't get the Nicki Minaj reference, but okay. We'll take a look. All right. Chalo. Bye,
I mean,
guys.
She's as old as you, Cyrus. You should know.
I heard that. I let it go. Because of COVID.
Next time.
Bye, everybody.